Hi everyone, my name is Sarah and I'm a scientist from Seattle Children's Hospital. I'm joining you from my laboratory in downtown Seattle today, and we are learning about DNA. Welcome back. Now, as a little bit of an introduction, I want to talk about DNA. Now, DNA is found inside of cells. Cells are very, very small, and they make up all living organisms. And we have many different types of cells inside of our bodies. So I have a few examples with me today. So I have a red blood cell, I have a white blood cell, I have a skin cell, a muscle cell, right, helps us to move around. Many different types of cells, and they all contain DNA. DNA is found inside of what's called the nucleus. And DNA is not the only thing inside of cells. There are many different components. So if we wanted to just look at DNA, we would have to do a DNA isolation experiment. Now, to isolate just means to get something by itself. So today, we're going to do a DNA isolation experiment for a strawberry. We will provide the protocol so you have all of the steps and materials you need to do this experiment yourself with the help of a parent or a guardian. So today I'm using a strawberry. You can also use a banana if you have that available. And everything that we're using is completely safe. I'm just wearing gloves because I'm in my laboratory today. So I'm gonna go ahead and start our experiment now. And I have my strawberry in a little Ziploc baggie, and I've sealed the top to make sure that everything stays within the little baggie here. Now the first step is to kind of mush the strawberry and break it up. And the reason that we're doing that is because cells, let's imagine they're kind of like balloons, right? If I had a balloon with a dollar bill inside of it, I would get to that dollar bill by just popping the balloon open, right? Same idea here. The DNA is inside of the cell, so we want to pop open the cell to release the DNA so that we can isolate it and work with it. So I'm going to start by just mashing up the strawberry, just very gently, just using my fingers. And I'm not doing this, you know, I'm not being very rough with the strawberry. I'm not, you know, using my fist or anything, right? I'm just gently mashing it up using my fingers, and that's more than enough. And so this is just breaking open those strawberry cells and releasing that DNA. I just want to make sure that I get all of the bigger chunks mashed up. And then once that's done, I'll go ahead and open up my baggie a little bit, and I'm going to pour in DNA extraction buffer. Now, this is just salt, soap, and water, so it's very safe. So I'm just going to slowly pour that into my little baggie here. And this will just help to break open any of those cells that are still together. We want to make sure to release that DNA, so this will just help that along. And I'll just mix it gently with my fingers, very gently like before. We don't want to be rough because it might break open the baggie, right? And we don't want that. And I'll just mix that together. And then once that's nice and mixed up, I'll go ahead and open one side of the baggie. And I have a cup here with a coffee filter inside. Now, you can also use gauze or even a paper towel if that's all that you have. And what I'm going to do is just very carefully pour my strawberry mixture inside the coffee filter. And it might drop down, but I want to make sure that all of the bigger chunks get inside of the filter. And this is where it's helpful to have another person helping you out. Make sure that all of the little bits of strawberry get in there. All right, so the reason that we're doing this is because the DNA is inside of the liquid portion of our strawberry mixture. So we want to get rid of all of those bigger chunks that weren't mashed up previously. And I'll help this along by holding the top of the filter and then just gently twisting to filter out all of the liquid that has our DNA inside. I'll just twist and let that filter out. And once that's done, I'll set that to the side, kind of wipe off my fingers a little bit. And right now, DNA is like a long, thin thread. So if I had a long, thin thread here in front of me, it would be very hard to see. But if I clumped that together into like a ball of yarn, that would make it much easier to see. So in order to do that for the DNA, we're going to use cold rubbing alcohol. Now this is just regular rubbing alcohol you can find in a grocery store or a pharmacy. And this is just going to help clump up that DNA so it's easier to see. And all I'm going to do is tilt the cup on its side and gently pour the cold rubbing alcohol down the side of the cup. And this will form a layer on top. And I can already see some cloudiness forming in the cup, and it's clumping up that DNA into a little ball so it's easier to see. And to help it along, I'll use a little wooden stick, and I'll gently swirl around to gather up all of our clumped up strawberry DNA. And there we go. All of that goopy material on the edge of this wooden stick, all of that is DNA. Now that's pretty amazing because DNA is very, very small. We can't see it with our eyes, and we would need something even more powerful than a microscope to be able to see it. So the fact that we're able to see our strawberry DNA like this is pretty amazing. All right, that is our experiment for today. I hope that you enjoyed and you try this out yourself. As I mentioned, we'll have the protocol available so you have all of the materials and steps that you need. And I hope that you enjoyed watching and we'll see you next time. Bye.